All right, lesson 1.6, part 2. This is solving compound inequalities. Compound inequalities come in two forms. They come in the form of an and. These are typically written with two inequality signs. So, for example, x, we have 3 is less than x, which is less than 8. And we would be looking for any number that fit into that category. So, 5, for example, because 5, 3 is less than 5, but 5 is also less than 8. Now, if we pick 10, for example, 3 is less than 10, which is less than 8. 3 is less than 10. However, 10 is not less than 8. So this is not a good example of an and problem. Okay? Has to satisfy, whenever we find the number, has to satisfy both equations, inequalities. Whenever we have an or, x is greater than 5, or x is less than or equal to negative 2. So an example of this would be if we picked, what if x was 8? We got eight is greater than 5. However, eight is not less than negative 2. So that would not be a good example. I mean, that would still be a good example because it only has to satisfy one. So this one has to satisfy both. This one only has to satisfy 1. Okay? All right, so when we're solving these, whenever you're solving an and question, okay, we have two inequalities. So we have two boundary lines, just like we did with the equal sign, that we need to take care of. So we're solving this thing for t. So the very first thing we need to do is to eliminate this minus 8. Now, since we have two boundary lines, not only are we going to add 8 in the middle in this case, but we need to add 8 on each side of those boundary lines. We already have the middle taken care of. Now we need to add 8 to the left side. We need to add 8 to the right side. So then we get negative 2 plus 8 is 6. Less than or equal to, bring down to 3t. Negative 8 plus 8 cancels. Less than or equal to, 10 plus 8 gives me 18. And then I divide by 3. But remember, when I divide by 3 in the middle to get rid of it with the t, I have to do it on each side of each of the boundary lines. So I can do it with this side, and I have to do it over here. Okay? So, then 6 divided by 3 gives me 2. 3's cancel out, so I get t. Less than or equal to 18 divided by 3 is 6. So my answer is 2 is less than or equal to t, which is less than or equal to 6. Okay? The next example is a you try. So go ahead and pause the video at this time. And when you're finished, check your answer to make sure that you're correct. Okay, your answer should have been negative 13 is less than t, which is less than 6. Make sure you add or subtract 4 from each side of those boundary lines. On an or question, the only thing we have to do is we just have to make sure and solve each variable, okay, or each inequality. So you basically just have two problems to do. So in this one, we're going to subtract 3 first. So 2x is less than 2. Divide by 2. And x would be less than 1. Or, gotta have the or. And then you solve this one. Add 7. 4x is less than 16. Divide by 4. X is greater than 4. So x could be less than 1, or x could be greater than 4. Okay. Next one is a you try, so go ahead and pause the video at this time. Solve the inequality. When you're finished, restart the video and check your answer. Okay, your answer should have been less than negative 1 or x is greater than 7. Okay? This concludes lesson 1.6 part 2, solving compound inequalities. Make sure you complete your quick check today and your practice problems.